and the world champion Philadelphia Eagles face off with Jameis Winston and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. With that, let's get you over to Raymond James Stadium for the home opener. On the call, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
We are just a few miles from the Gulf Coast of Florida at Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with the Philadelphia Eagles. Hi again, everyone. Brandon Godden alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, you take a look at this Buccaneer ball club. They come in off a loss in the opener last week. That one was on the road. Now they get their first taste here of home cooking.
And what they're hoping to do is feed off the energy of the home crowd. Great tailgate, great fan support. Let's see if they can put it to good use.
Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Eagles, they too were losers last week, so they're also hoping to get back in the win column.
Something's got to...
Team set to lace it up. This ought to be fun, and we're underway on EA Sports. On the return, this is Jaquizz Rodgers. And a good return is going to be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. So out come the Bucs now for their first drive. They'll be led out by their 6'4" quarterback, the former number one overall pick in 2015, Jameis Winston.
And no excitement unless you're on the defensive team of last week in his numbers, because the only excitement he really generated was the one interception he threw.
Yeah, no touchdown pass.
Yeah, and his team wasn't real thrilled about that. And they lost the game. So I know this week has been tough on him because he's been working hard. Fundamentals, footwork, finding the right targets. And how do they get a win?
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. And we get a glance now at the Buccaneer offense.
And my eyes immediately go to Mike Evans. Four straight 1,000-yard seasons to begin his career. His numbers may have dropped a little bit in 2017, but he commands respect from every defense with his height and his ability to run downfield and make a big catch.
And a first carry here for Charles Sims. And he works his way forward for a couple up past the 30. And the defense now for the Eagles.
Coming up injury in 2017, middle linebacker Jordan Hicks is an important part of the Eagles' wide nine defense. When you hear that term, think about the defensive ends out wider than normal to have a better angle to rush the quarterback. So that means guys like Jordan Hicks, who play middle linebacker, have to be able to fill in the holes against the running game, and he does that very effectively.
Ready, blue ready.
The play fake to Sims, now Winston. Airing this one out for Evans. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. Back deep is Darren Sproles. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. Leading the charge under center will be their 6'5" quarterback, Carson Wentz.
Now the meeting we had with him this week, that's one of the briefer ones we've ever had, isn't it?
He wasn't too happy after last week.
Not happy, really determined to play a whole lot better, and he really can't play a whole lot worse. He's got to go out and show the team that the goods that he exhibited earlier are still there. Otherwise, he could lose the confidence that they have in
him. Looking to get that interception ball. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. They know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production. But I dare say this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that's in the pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah,
Rush, now second and 10.
On the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end, and that gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Call a no game there, and it leads to a fourth down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
So out come the Bucs now. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again, so he's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball to their territory.
There he goes again. Oh, he's got some breathing room. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. The 30. The 20. Touchdown. Charles Sims. 97 yards. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead. Good start to the season for Indy. The touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. Then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far, so good for him. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trade expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. Then we'll get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Eluding the pressure right. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be 2nd down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on 1st down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable 2nd and short.
They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. They fake the give. Now wins. Pressure too much. Down he goes. Jason Pierre-Paul. Able to drop him for a loss of a couple. And an early sack there for Tampa Bay. Charles, that is a welcome sight.
A sight for sore eyes, you might say, right? Just 22 sacks on the season in 2017. And what they're hoping that some of their one-on-one guys can get home this year instead of having to scheme to try and get sacks.
And those 22 sacks last in the league a year ago.
Come on now.
And
come on now.
Third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Shotgun now for Wentz. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a 1st down.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 47. That was the all-purpose back. This is Darren Sproles. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. Moving back
Well, it changes your play call, definitely, because as a play call, you're advancing yourself thinking, okay, we're going to get a gain here. Now you've got to go back in reverse, come up with something to pick up not just the yardage lost, but gain a few extra. In the offseason about him having a big year and getting to the quarterback. They held him without a sack in week one, but how about here? Finally gets his first one of the season.
In the offseason, said he changed his diet, leaner, feels so good this year. Excited to see what type of a season he can have. They're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21.
Ready? Y 25.
The football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware of ball making.
Will go with an extra DB here as they prepare for a stop on third.
Thinking pass all the way.
Ready. Black 22.
From the shotgun, it's Winston. He's got Collins. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Give him 35 yards there on the third down conversion.
I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they put field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Chain mover. They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10.
Ready. Blue way.
Sims. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Not much there. Maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40.
And that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Certainly spread the ball around a bit, and this is a guy the defenses have better focus on.
Now they run with Sims. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he's stopped behind the line of scrimmage. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and that'll bring up a third down.
Situations, 9.5 sacks last season in Seattle, and the smallest shoulder pads for a man his size we've ever seen.
And a three-time Pro Bowler to boot. On is Chandler Catanzaro now for the Buccaneer field goal. He's going to need a little mustard on this one. It will be a 51-yard attempt. And Catanzaro's kick is right through, and the lead moves to 10-0. Get to the field goal try. Time will run out on this first quarter of play. It's the Bucs with the early lead. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Bucs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter, as we'll see one following the score on the final play before break. It's Marcus Wheaton now to return it. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Eagles coming out as they get ready. They've had it twice. They punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
Here's a handoff to a Ajayi to begin the first play. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Here we go. Wentz to throw on second down. And this is Wentz with it, right side. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. An Eagle first down there, Wentz to Ertz, and the names that end in TZ.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
Going on first. lost his wins. They dump off underneath to Ajayi. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down. They couldn't get anything going there out on the right side of the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved in the
big
passing
emphasis.
Game? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously the defense had other plans and really made a nice play.
They'll run it now. Out of bounds. And that play go absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game. Really in the point of attack, the offensive line's just getting pushed around. I think now as a play caller, you got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence because you can't abandon the play calling right now.
Now Wentz on third down. Trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. They're trying to rush Renzi's confidence. Last week was a disaster. 5 interceptions in that loss, and another pick there.
I played with a quarterback like this before, and he had a tough game. And the head coach said, "I'll take him. I'll fix him." The very next game, he started out the exact same way. The head coach turned to the offense coordinator and said, "He's yours from now on." Someone has to take responsibility and work with it and try and get him settled.
Winston and the Bucs take over now, first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48.
Ready, blue lady.
Following the interception, Winston. Falkers running back and he's got him complete. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Second and 12 after the first down pass play went backwards for 2 yards. Play fake. Winston. And a catch right side by Evans. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
When Mike Evans sees man coverage, I don't think he's the only guy who gets excited. I guarantee the guy throwing the ball does, because guess what? He's got a lot of options about where to place it because of Mike Evans' size and frame.
But sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it. When you're running the route tree in pregame, you don't have defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to replicate the intensity of the game in pregame.
Encroachment, defense.
So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football.
Still second down.
Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
After the encroachment penalty, here's second and 5. Again, it's Winston. And he fires one, it's intercepted. Good tackle by the linebacker, Jordan Hicks. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
The Eagles Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful not being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Hang in there now. Hang in there now.
Moving forward, this defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
So after the run by Jay Ajayi, here's first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. He's taken down. Jason Pierre-Paul in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon.
That's a pretty darn good start to his season, huh? A sack in the opener and a second one here. That tells you about his offseason. He came in determined to have a big year, and it's paying off.
They'll look to make amends on a second down and 17.
Here we go, here we go. Sweeney! What's that?
What's that? Wentz now to throw. Wentz over the middle. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
The Eagles on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and 7.
Hoping for there as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. He's in his own second quarter, already closing in on a 100-yard game.
And that's the magic number for a running back. Anytime you get to that triple digits, that's all you're looking for. But he's got a chance to really exceed that in this one.
Yeah, he does. That's been the gold standard for a long time, hasn't it, that 100-yard mark?
It really has, and that never has to shift because it's in a game. It's a 1,000-yard mark. I'm wondering, since we've gone from 12 to 14 to 16 games, they need to up that a little.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Now Sims. And the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup. And now they've got a third down and 8.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a third and long at the outside of his route. And he's got it past the 30. hit and dropped. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
And this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. Anyone playing the linebacker position, when they see a running back down the backfield, because he heads towards the flat first, oftentimes you widen too much and overcommit. He cuts up inside, and that's what we saw there. A nice pickup for a first down.
Winston now to throw on first down. And Winston lost the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. So they take over not only in enemy territory, but in the red zone at the 16-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here.
They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot. Great opportunity to run your full playbook. They want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it.
Now after the fumble recovery, it's Wentz. It's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Short of the marker by just a yard, leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1.
From the gun, it's Wentz. A dump off to Sproles. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the 1st and goal.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read.
This is taken in by Jeffrey. He's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. Alshon Jeffrey, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Eagles are back within a score. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. Elliott good with a PAT. And that'll cut it to 3 at 10-7. Elliott now to kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
They're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Evans has a rush on. And finally, he goes out of bounds right at the 35-yard line. It's a big play, Winston to Evans, and even 40 yards. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll send you cross state to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have all the stats and all the scores from games going on during another busy Sunday in the National Football League. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Now 1st and 10, Winston. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play zone defense when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands. Guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
Ready. Blue ready.
A 2nd down throw for Winston. tight end Cameron Brait was the target. And now it's third down.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
To the air again with Winston. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Now the Eagles going to send her for a timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. And it is good. Well, that one looked to be in trouble the whole way, but it does get over the ball. And the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Wheaton will return it. Turn there, gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things.
They'll begin the drive with Foles. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. And Wentz throwing out second down. It's complete. Left side. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. It goes as a gain of 8. It moves the chains. Wentz now on first down. This is taken in one-handed. What a catch.
Hang in there now. Hang in
there. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was now streaking towards him. That little arm guard, he's got to find a way to get his head around him and make the play.
Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half.
Come on now, oh, come on now, let's go.
On second down, here's Wentz. He finds a Johnny. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Wentz now 13 of 16 throwing the football. It's first and 10. Jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
It is tough to complete pass against zone defenses. The windows that you see open, they shrink pretty rapidly. How about being able to hit a moving target against a zone before the next guy can get there and make a play on the ball?
Not easy for any quarterback, no matter the situation. And there, the defense won the battle. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Working from the gun, Wentz. Is down and goes. Harris spins. In there to sack him for a loss of 6. So Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack.
Go, go. 80.
So we've hit halftime here in Tampa with a box out in front. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, we'll get back to you two in a bit. For now, plenty of early game action around the NFL to get you caught up on, so let's get to it. We'll start things out with a trip up to FedEx Field. Washington playing host to visiting Indianapolis. And it's the Colts who have the lead in the second quarter. The Colts trying to gut this one out, as it would be a good victory for them if they could get it. From there, we head on over to Wisconsin to check on the Packers at home at Lambeau Field. And it's the visiting Minnesota Vikings who are out in front. Two touchdown passes for Kirk Cousins there. Finally, we're off to Atlanta to check on the Falcons at home at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. And for the moment, they find themselves trailing the visiting Carolina Panthers. Devin Funchess, a touchdown reception. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Bucs with the lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Out come the Eagles now as they'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this of intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works.
Come on now, Ollie. Come on now. Let's go.
Across the 30 to the 31-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to third down.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try to chip someone at the second level.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. It goes for a gain of 10, and it's a first down. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed.
But
when you have that type
of
height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because when they're hoping this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On play action, it's Wentz. And he kicked out a receiver, and he's brought down. Jason Pierre-Paul getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offense
defensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Now flags come in here. Look like one of the Eagles might have moved.
False start, offense.
Maybe anticipating a blitz and they jumped.
Yeah, and if we saw it, you know that they saw it. The bad guys might have been coming on that play. Had to pick them up and they jumped.
And the blitz does come. And we'll just toss it away. So he throws it away and that brings up fourth down. There was the pressure you were talking about, forcing incompletion.
And it doesn't always have to end in a sack, does it? Sometimes you can make a good play by forcing the incompletion with the pressure.
Here's Donnie Jones now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Yeah, that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get out to you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense, we got the lead. Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
He's got a wide open complete. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. He has a first down, and that catch will also put him over 100 yards receiving now in the afternoon. They'll run here with Sims. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now whistles here before the snap. Look like one of the Bucs may have moved.
False start, offense.
And that'll set them back five. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and
ready.
Long.
Ready.
Throw, Winston. And they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. They'll give him a yard on the play, and that's going to lead to a third and 12.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
The Bucs on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third down and 12.
Ready, black, 22.
Working out of the gun, Winston. A dump off to Sims. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that's going to bring up the fourth down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
Here's Brian Anger now. They'll boot it away from about his 35. And that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep him warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7. Stop made there by Gerald McCoy.
Gerald McCoy is always going to be linked with Ndamukong Suh. They came into the NFL in the same draft class. There was a lot of debate about who was going to be the better defensive tackle. They just do it two different ways. McCoy, more movement, more elusiveness. That allowed him to make the play there for a short gain.
Yeah, he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the gain, and it's third and two now. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
They'll run it now. Out of the gun. Fighting through, and he's got space. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped.
I think I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there. And what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And able to use his blockers to get this off over the 40. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid game. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there. The sacks have been coming at him all game long. I'm frankly surprised that they haven't found a solution yet to create more time for him to throw it or maybe change what they do on offense.
And that's one of the biggest differences in this game and why they're losing right now. To throw his lands.
Second half now. This is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. There's Donnie Jones now as he's on for the fifth time here today. Mike Evans and the rest of the offensive unit heading back out there now. And I know that they double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it? Usually it opens it up to other people have big games as well.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
These guys be without his performance on the ground. That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
To Sims, now Winston. And he'll run it out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. It's a pickup of 16 there to the lead to a new set of downs.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar. You circle the Bowl without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
Good plays have him on the move on first down.
Ready.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. There he goes outside.
Contributing to their lead, he has to continue to do so.
Ready?
From the gun, Winston. And this is going to be caught. It's good. And that extends their lead by two more. So they go with a pass there on the two-point try and able to convert it, Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their two-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
It really is. I don't know how much that particular play factored in, but with the PAT moving back in 15-16, that kind of changed things, didn't it?
It's really a part of everyone's strategy now. When I talk with coaches and when we sit with them, they're always talking about they actually have two-point periods in practice now, something they never really did before.
And out now come the Eagles. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
90 points.
Big time.
Wentz going to throw. Throw over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver. And it's second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in by making the plays that they've made, and that just means they're one big score away from being right back in.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game.
Illegal touching. Offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. The Eagles on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This is third and 10.
Here we go.
Shotgun down at the Wentz. It's caught by Aguilar. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. The completion good for the 6, and that'll bring up 4. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
So far. And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. But look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. He is hoping to find the end zone for a third time, and we sit now in the third quarter.
And nothing would excite him more, but I think even more so, his offensive line. Anytime you've got a guy scoring that many times, that means you've done a really nice job in front of him.
You're always giving props to the big fellas up front.
It's always a good idea. This is a massive miss.
And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way. Lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guy, you're energized. Executed well, and you caught the loss yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Plus, the secondary guys don't have a lot of tackles.
So, first and 10 now from the 30.
Right back to him on first down. He takes this from the 30 to the 34.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Let's go now.
Second down, Winston. He's going to flip that out to his running back. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. It goes as a loss of six. And now third down.
Ready. That play was well covered. Just tried to check it down. Unfortunately, not able to find any yardage on that one.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Tampa. It's the Bucs. They've got the football. They also are in front here on the scoreboard as we start the fourth. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. From the shotgun, it's Winston. He's going to sling this deep downfield. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down. Despite the lead here in the fourth, they're still taking shots.
Not content to sit on this lead at all. To me, it raises the question of, what's right in this game nowadays? Do you sit on the ball and run it because you have enough of a lead? Or do you try and extend it because you always feel like the other team can come back?
Extend it. Have some fun. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. Now, if you're a fan of punting, and I know that not many people are, but this game kind of turning into one for you.
Well, it's okay if it's a skills contest, right? We're really into it then, but not during the course of an actual game. This has turned into a field position game, though. Sometimes a better punter may actually determine the outcome.
On first down, Wentz. He's going to loft it deep right sideline. And he goes out of bounds across the opposite 40. Nelson Aguilar, the intended receiver.
This defense is definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Have to take a peek and see whether or not the receiver was able to dot the eye with both feet
while making sure that he possesses the football all the way through the catch.
Challenge pays dividends. The ref overturns the play.
Everyone gets a bonus on this one, Brandon. The coach upstairs who says he's signaled down.
The guy's man complete. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10, just outside the 30. Throwing on first is Wentz. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves them with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Wentz to throw on second down. And his throw is incomplete. Chris Conte right there to break that one up.
this close to the goal line, you got to be very careful with the offense called rub routes. When I call a pick trying to screen you off from your coverage, does a nice job of avoiding that and helping force an incompletion.
And this is going to be incomplete.
So it looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
And the kick by Elliott is good. And the drive will wind up yielding three. So they put together a good little drive there, but ultimately stalling out in the red zone.
Yeah, I know a lot of people look at it as a little bit of a negative. They didn't get 6 points out of it, right? Didn't get the touchdown. But that's actually okay. They got 3 points. It will give the defense a little bit of rest, let them settle down over there. So all in all, the games, that's a good drive.
That is up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. He has a chance to hit that often elusive 200-yard mark on this drive.
And most of the time during a game, people aren't keeping track of individual statistics.
Are you sure?
Well, a lot of the runners kind of know. But I'll guarantee you, someone has sent word into the offensive line that he's got a chance to get over 200 on this drive. That should give them a little extra motivation.
Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack.
Brandon, more often than not, you'd say they've had his number, and we can count them up so far. 1, 2, 3, 4 sacks given up. But guess what? He's still been able to make some plays, and right now they have a lead.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Given 14 on the play. And they're going to have a third down.
It seemed like the situation was second and a mile to go for a first down. But screams wreck. Throw the football. You got to pass in order to try and pick up that kind of yardage. But in this case, they ran a tendency breaker.
Ready.
Because
watch
the tendency is for defenses to be out there and be set up for the pass. So you break tendency and actually run the football. That changes everything because if you're able to find a crease, you often have bigger guys working against smaller guys downfield. They picked up excellent yardage there to bring up a third down. You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy can hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. Here's Brian Anger now. He's been terrific so far. And he gets this away. Look at this. This is a good one. This is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily, though.
The first play of the drive there is incomplete. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. Again from the 20 after the incompletion. Here's second and 10.
Four there. Don't go.
Once again here on second and 10. And he turned it loose. It's incomplete. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard. The Eagles on third down. They've had a lot of chances, but not much success, converting only 3 times. This is third and 10.
Get up.
Twins. And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down.
I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
So a change of possession here on the punt, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Now a carry here for Orleans Darkwine. Solid move, but he's corralled just beyond the 40. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football. And they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. Yeah, my music teacher is back in Newport. This is about being a bad boy. He used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go longer. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. This lead, confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they have to ride all the way to the finish. The strategy would tell you run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done.
That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven.
Everyone's got four. Four ready. Blue ready.
Now they'll run on the ground. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 9 yards on the play there. It sets him up first and goal.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well conditioned. And he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Now Winston. And he's got it. Caught the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Tris Sims. His third touchdown of the game and fourth on the year. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead. This offense certainly looking a lot more comfortable here at home. They lost last week in the opener on the road, but there's something about that home opener makes you feel more settled.
Yeah, I wish we could quantify it, too, because you're playing the same game. The field's the same, you know, size. We know all of that. But being at home, sometimes when you do things well, you get that extra push from your home fans, and it elevates your game.
And in the driver's seat right now. Extra point up and good by Catanzaro. And the lead is up to 18 now. Kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Eagles' offense now, they head back on the field, and on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Well, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time, hopefully with a chance to win?
We'll come up now, 2nd and 4 from the 31. Rolling now is Wentz. Incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up 3rd down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. Here's Wentz to throw. Escaping, he goes down. Mitch online. Able to get him down for a loss of 11 on the play. And it'll be 4th down.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never put themselves in the middle of almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury.
A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on 4th down. Now Wentz, got to have this one. He's going to look deep down the field. And this is going to be incomplete. Well, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down 3 scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
Now the Buccaneer offense gets set to take over.
Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football. The turnover on downs, the most recent example, and now, obviously, they're in a great spot here.
If you're over on the bench right now, you're shaking hands with your teammate, you're hugging him, give him a little dap. Been a big performance for them. Now you just don't get careless, take care of the ball.
Throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
Hey. And they'll run it here. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Tackle that time by Sidney Jones.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stop that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
On 3rd down, Winston. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
And Catanzaro's kick is right through. And that will stretch the lead up to 3 touchdowns now. It's a 21-point game. So it's 3 more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Time for us now to discuss Alshon Jeffrey. They might want to mix something up defensively because he's been shredding them a bit, hasn't he?
That he has, and even with all the changes that you know are going on the defensive side of the ball, he's still finding ways to get open, finding the right spots, and the delivery's been pretty good, too.
As over 100 yards, has the 1 touchdown score to this point. What's that throw? Jeffrey with a catch left side. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player.
We'll check on his status when we get back. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now, because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Now Wentz again. Williams that time, and it's third down.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
The fourth quarter, maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there, the legs still there? This has been a tough game. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Wentz now on first down. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Sure, I know who this guy is out there playing right now. This is very unlike him, one of the most accurate guys in the league. Totally off his game right now.
I don't know. I was going to ask you what you pin it on, but defensively, they've been pretty solid.
Now, sometimes, you know, those defenders, they get into the receivers pretty well, and they're checking it out.
And down he goes. A bucket and sack. Gerald McCoy in there to record another sack. They're 6 of the afternoon.
Because every team has a goal when they start the year to win at home. And sometimes you don't win all of them, but they managed to get that done today. Just think about your routine stays the same. Everything's familiar. You feel right going into the game, and they translated that into a win.
They did indeed. They protected the home field, and now the final stages.
Let's go now.
Way forward to about the 32. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
On 3rd down, it's Sims. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on 4th. Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.